the fourth time in their career. Remember, it was Connie Kalitta who won here back in 1994. But will it be J.R. Todd who gains automatic entrance to the Traxxas with his first win of the year? Or will Dougie keep him down, go back to back, something he hasn't done since 2006? For more on Connie Kalitta, the bounty hunter, here's Jamie.
Well, in talking with Jim Oberhofer, he was telling me that mechanically these two cars are exactly the same, but from a setup standpoint, they are not as similar as the organization would like it. Why? Because Connie Kalitta is going to put his own spin on it. He's going to keep the rest of the team guessing no matter what anyone else says.
And Connie has a penchant to do that. Jim Oberhofer kind of has his ideas. Connie has his ideas. Sometimes they mesh, sometimes they don't. But that's what's going to make this a compelling final.
Well, Connie's old school. He's been doing this for a long time. And it's, to some degree, the SealMaster car is his toy. But he's a smart racer. And both of these cars are evenly matched. Doug ran quicker. He actually almost matched his qualifying time at 3:73. But J.R. Todd's not far behind. In terms of experience, they both have a lot of experience. Doug Kalitta has a little bit of a rhythm because he's been in several final rounds this year. So J.R. Todd, I'm going to give him a good chance. This may be one of the best races of the day.
And a mosh pit is just a few seconds away, but in which lane? Give it up for Doug Kalitta. Margin of victory, 0-0-0-0. Second time it happened in pro stock back in Bristol. Margin of victory dead even. NHRA's computers can take it out a little further, but wait till we see this one on the Lucas Oil photo finish cam. You gotta be kidding me. Dougie left on him by 21 thousandths of a second, but JR outran the Mack Tools car by 21 thousandths of a second. That Goodyear stripe is going to show two wings matched up evenly.
Well, when a driver like Doug Kalitta comes into a final, when I talk about rhythm, drivers have confidence. It allows them to get in a rhythm. It allows them to leave the starting line. J.R. Todd has nothing to be ashamed with. Both of these cars performed. Both of these cars, more importantly, entertained all of these fans that came out to watch.
Oh, my, the shot I've been looking for. Electronics decide that it's the Mack Tools car by the narrowest of margins that crossed the stripe first in an absolute dead heat. Incredible stuff. Bruno.
When you're living right, you race your teammate in the final, and you win that final on an absolute mathematical dead heat. Jim, you're living right today.